you know, he's white and black in the blood. And you're just like, no, man, I grew up watching that guy play at AC Milan. Then AC Milan didn't want him anymore. He joined Juventus. He won more, but he's not a Juventus legend. Anyways, okay, good luck, Andrea.
Fair. Yeah, fair.
Yeah, then I've got a little prediction for the top scorer.
So I think it might be maybe not an obvious choice. I think most people would go for the Portuguese, but who are you going to go for as top scorer this year?
I'd go for the Belgian beast.
Yeah.
Romelu Lukaku. I mean, he's had a very impressive first season, to say the least. 23 goals in 36 Serie A games for Inter. He's shown a lot of confidence. He's proved that he can pretty much be a captain, you know? His confidence was always there. He didn't miss a single penalty. I was very worried about that just because at the beginning I had contrasting feelings about him. But then he just had an incredible season. He's a great leader. And if I have to say one thing that he lacks sometimes, he lacks finesse. In the Europa League final, for example, the Sevilla goalkeeper was coming out. He could have gone around him, chipped him, and he just shot the ball straight at him. I think he needs to improve from that point of view.
Well, I think this is something that was leveled at him while he was at Manchester United. It's interesting to see the transformation in him since he's come to Italy, because I feel like at Manchester United, he was scapegoated a little bit for the problems in that team. Now, he may well have been part of the problem, but he wasn't the problem. And I think it has been amazing for him to come to Inter and become such an integral part of that team so quickly. And the form that he has hit, some of the performances, like the semi-final against Shakhtar, there was one, I think it was his second goal.
Did you see the acceleration, though?
He just, for the size of him, he looks like he could play NFL. Like that kind of huge guy who can do 100 meters in 10 seconds. If you know what I mean? Like, it is incredible. And
EA Sports doesn't think so, though.
No,
rating?
The riots.
He was pretty offended.
The riots all over Twitter by players this week has been quite entertaining. But I think I'm enjoying seeing him transformed from his time in England, because by the end at Manchester United, he just looked defeated. He looked like he had the world on his shoulders. And I think Inter, the fans adore him, and it is all about him. And I think he's found his home here, potentially. So, and, you know, last season, better record than, again, El Fenomeno. We're giving him a bit of a bashing this week.
Yeah,
he's my favourite
yeah.
player. But, you know, he has a better record than him. And I think, yeah, he's been incredible since he got here. So why not, right?
Yeah. And then, overall, great guy. He just seems to be very happy to be in Milan. And he's playing in a team. Well, let's talk about Inter since we're at it. I mean, I'm not the only one who thinks that. Looking at Inter's squad, Inter are the title contenders. They have to take the title from Juve. I think that Juve have a better shot at it because they're used to it. They have a group that has worked together for many years. Pirlo, now, maybe he's not the greatest coach. He doesn't have that experience, but he used to play with some of the players that he will now manage. However, I think Inter are title contenders. They've done pretty well on the market as well. Hakimi, hello.
If we're going to talk about pace.
Yeah, one of the fastest players in Europe.
I think he's
moment.
Only behind Alphonso Davies, right?
He is, actually.
Yeah.
He is. Goal scorer. He scored a 2 against Inter Milan last year. God, irony, right? Kolarov is pretty good signing.
He's there to do a job. The wing backs in Conte's system are so key. And I think Kolarov is there to do a job. He's going to hit maybe 5 or 6 free kicks. And he's going to defensively solid. Okay, maybe at 37, the pace isn't quite there. But he knows that he's a good, when he comes on, he's going to get the job done. I think that's a very clever signing.
Definitely. And then we've got treble hero Ivan Perisic back. I'm an Inter fan. Inter don't know if they're going to keep him, if he's staying or not. There are a few teams interested. I hope he stays. He's shown who he is. I've always known he was a great player, and I'm very happy for the treble win.
From watching him when he was at Inter, I think my first year when I was in Milan, obviously a very gifted player, but I feel like he is anonymous too often.
Yeah.
Sometimes in games, you just don't notice him.
Very true.
And I think when he turns up, he can absolutely ruin defenders for 90 minutes. But if you look at his statistics, they're still not that great. Like for Bayern in 22 games, it's 4 goals and 6 assists. Now, that's not bad, but from a left winger, you maybe want a bit more output, yep. right? Yeah. I think he's a good, again, a good other option for Inter. I think what lost them the title last year was potentially lack of squad depth. Like Juve have options coming off the bench and Inter didn't. And I think Conte made that very public. So I think maybe these are the types of players that could take Inter that step further.
Type of players like Rajo Nainggolan, who's also back from the loan to
Cagliari. That guy I love. That guy I love.
And then also Sensi seems to be fit again. Sensi, I don't know if you remember the beginning of last season. People were looking at him rather than Barella. Then Barella stepped up. Then Sensi got injured. But Sensi, man, just wait for the guy to be in shape. And he is a weapon, just like Christian Eriksen. Inter have a lot of great players. We just have to rely on Conte to create really the feeling of a team that wants to win. A team that is hungry, that is fed up with not winning shit for 10 years. And they want to win again. That's it. All right. I've said it all about Inter.
I would quickly just say about Sensi, guys, check out his tattoos. The tattoo on his hand is ridiculous. From what
Isn't
I can
that
see,
the panda emoji?
Cartoon panda or something.
I think it's the panda emoji.
I had to Google it when I saw it in play, and I was like, what the hell is that? Oh, right.
Okay. He's a great guy, though. I bumped into him in Milan a few weeks ago, and it was very fun. He just smiled.
He seems like a lot of fun. I've seen his Instagram. He's around Milan on those scooters, messing around and stuff. He seems like a good guy.
Yeah, just, okay, play with the scooters. Don't get injured again. All right, let's move on. I've got a few other predictions.
So the next one is, who do you think are going to be the overachievers? Who are the dark horses for this season?
All right, so this one could be a very controversial take to many, but I think that this team are long overdue to be on the top half of the Serie A table. They haven't been for a long time. 2 years ago, they were risking relegation. In the end, they stayed in the top flight. I'm talking about a historical team, Fiorentina. This time, I think that they could go actually better than the last years. So they've signed Bonaventura from AC Milan, whom I don't think is a bad signing. He's a little old, but he's got a lot of experience, good pace.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of Milan fans quite upset that he's left. I think a few of them have been like, they've wished him well and been like, okay, I didn't see that come in. But yeah, we're glad he's gone to a good club that are going to give him a chance.
Also,
right?
Ibrahimovic spoke openly about this, and he said that he was one of the greatest leaders in AC Milan's locker room. So yeah, they've got Bonaventura, they got Amrabat from Verona, who had a very good season last year. They've got one of the brightest talents in Italian football at the moment, Gaetano Castrovilli. Woo! I know you like him, Rory.
This guy, I'm sorry, it's only taken 2 episodes for Football Manager to be mentioned, but this guy captained my Arsenal team to Champions League success and Premier League success. So for me, he's already a hell of a transfer for Fiorentina. He's, as far as I'm aware, a very creative midfielder, kind of box to box, lots of energy. A very good prospect that I think with the team they're kind of building along with, they're trying to build this kind of youth project going. I think that's a very clever signing.
Do you agree with me that Fiorentina are long overdue the top half of the table?
The last time I remember them being good is Batigol, is the last time I remember them being good. And that was late 90s, right?
The Nintendo jersey, all that.
That is on my all-time have-to-buy shirts, that sponsor.
Yeah, and the last time they won a title was actually in 2001. They won a Coppa Italia. Their fans have been 19 years without seeing a trophy.
I think, a huge club. They were one of the seven sisters,
for such an important city as well. And good luck, Fiorentina. You are my overachievers.
Underachievers.
Quite controversially, my underachievers are Atalanta. Okay.
What? Come on.
Yes. Okay. So it's a very hot take. Let me explain. So Atalanta were playing great football last year. They advanced until the Champions League semifinals, which was incredible. But they lost and they ended the season without really achieving anything. The thing that worries me about Atalanta is that last year, one day they would be scoring 8 goals, and the next game they would be losing to Spal at home.
Okay.
So, I mean, you can score, I don't care how many goals you score on average per game, but then if you play the bottom of the table, Spal, at home, you cannot lose 2-1. So who are you? Are you this powerhouse who can make Pep Guardiola and his team say, wow, these guys are scary to play against? Or are you the team that just, that shrinks in front of smaller opponents? I mean, Atalanta play great football. They're beautiful to watch. They were a beautiful story to follow. I was hoping, despite hating this team, because they always give Inter a hard time, especially when we play in Bergamo. I'm not a big fan of Atalanta in general, but I was rooting for them because, especially after all the COVID situation in Bergamo and all that, it would have been a beautiful story for them to win the Champions League. I mean, it was incredible. But now, have they set the bar a little too high? Will they be able to live up to their expectations? Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if Atalanta didn't finish top four.
Well, I'm going to slightly disagree with you, but I feel like with teams like this, when they achieve something or come so close to achieving something unexpected and it doesn't quite happen, it's a bit like after the Lord Mayor's show, and it's a bit, the next season tends to be a bit of a disappointment. So I can see where you're coming from. I think that would have taken a big toll on the squad to get so close within a minute of a Champions League final. I think there's still enough there for them to be kind of regularly qualifying for the Champions League. I would be surprised if they didn't next year. But yeah, we'll see, right?
They also got a few players. Cristian Romero on loan with option from Juventus. They purchased him from Genoa. He's a center back. He's pretty good. They also got Miranchuk, who's a very exciting young forward. He scored 12 goals in 25 games in the Russian Premier League last year. And this year, he's played only 4 games before moving to Atalanta, and he scored 2 goals. So he's a pretty exciting young talent to follow. And going back to Fiorentina before, let's not forget that Ribery plays for them. And if he's in shape, he can be a weapon.
I did forget that.
He was injured for most of last season, but he's back.
I did forget that. But with Atalanta, I feel like it's similar to the kind of Leicester thing, where this is a team that have a very good track record of spotting talent. Yeah. So I feel like, again, with Milanchuk, maybe they've found another striker that can fire them into the Champions League.
Now, very quickly going through 4 pretty important teams of the Serie A that we were not very impressed with. Lazio, Roma. How do you feel about the capital?
Now, I know this annoys you, but when I was a child, Roma were the first team in Italy that I did like. So I always kind of keep an eye out for them. And this year, it feels like, I'm not really sure what's happening there. They seem to have sold most of their players with Dzeko. It looks like Dzeko might be going if Suarez doesn't join Juventus, or maybe they get both. I don't know.
They will get both. I think so.
Maybe they'll get to keep hold of Dzeko, but they've sold quite a few players this summer, so I'm not really sure what's happening there. But they've brought in Mkhitaryan, who, thank you, Roma, because he was terrible for us, but he was quite good for them last year. It feels like they've been in transition for about 4 or 5 years through about 2 or 3 different managers.
And Zaniolo, who's the star of the team, he's injured.
Such a key player missing for the season could be huge for them, I think.
Lazio also are a team, in my opinion, that could have the same problems as Atalanta, not being able to live up to their expectations. Last year, they had an incredible season. I do think that Ciro Immobile is a great striker, but they had a lot of penalties awarded last year.
I also get the feeling that they rely on him a lot.
Yeah.
That if he doesn't score, not many other people do.
Yeah. And they've signed Fares, who's a pretty good wing back from Spal, and Muriqi, who is a forward from the Turkish Super League. He played for Fenerbahce, and he scored 15 goals in 32 games with 6 assists.
Yeah, quite impressive for your first season at a club, and then you've gone straight away. Like, that's an impressive season, right?
Very quickly, going north to Milan, the other team of Milan. What's the name? AC?
Yeah, I think that's the one.
AC Milan. AC Milan, they've signed, Ibrahimovic. Ibrahimovic is always a good signing. I'm excited, despite being an Inter fan, to see him for a full season at Milan. They signed Tonali. Man, Tonali, they've got to chill a second with Tonali. You cannot compare him to Pirlo and Gattuso at the same time. It's full
They're
of
two very different players, right? Different players.
They say he's got the grit of Gattuso, but the vision of Pirlo. And you're like, man, this guy's young.